Well, good morning. Today, I would discuss about chapter number 3. And from chapter number 3, one topic is there. That is, Santhal Rebellion. The period of Santhal Rebellion, you can see here, 1855-1856. The Santhal Rebellion is very important. It's important in this respect that it was started 2 years before the Great Revolt of 1857. That is why in this respect it's very important. Now we will see that some term has been used when we will discuss about Santhal Rebellion. Some term has been used for the Santhal Rebellion. Number first term, that is Hool. Here the question is asked in exam that what do you mean by Hool, or Hool is related to which revolt? So the answer is, if this question is asked in MCQ, then the answer will be, four options will be there. The right answer will be Santhal. Santhal is related to, or Hool is related to Santhal. Now another question will be asked to you, that what is the meaning of the term Hool? In Santhali language, Hool means rebellion or revolt. Afterwards, we can see that another term, Santhal. What is the meaning of the term Santhal? So we can say that the meaning of the term Santhal, who are Santhals? They were the hard-working, peace-loving, agrarian tribal community living in the forest and totally dependent on the resources of the forest. And in the year 1832, British government had formed named Damaneco. You can see Damaneco, the British government founded Damaneco, and the Santhals came and established in Damaneco, and Damaneco is situated in Jharkhand. Now one question is asked in exam, that what do you mean by the term Damaneco? The meaning of the Damaneco, I have written here, that the border of the mountain. Damaneco means the border of the mountain. After that, when all the Santhals began to leave by the invitation of the British government, they came and began to live in Jharkhand. That is the new place established by British government, came to be known as Damaneco. Okay, they began to stay there. But after that, we see that a large number of Santhals, they came from Cuttack, Dalbhum, Hazaribagh, Manbhum, Midnapur, etc. They came and began to develop in a newly established place by British government named Damaneco. But very soon, misfortune knocked at the door of the Santhalis. And in these areas of the Santhali areas of in the Damaneco, the Mahajans and Zamindars also entered. And the Mahajan and Zamindars entered in the area of Damaneco as a tax collector employed by the British government to dominate economy. They began to extract the money from the Santhals. Not only that, the Bhikkhus, I have in my previous class discussed about Bhikkhus. Bhikkhus were the outsiders. Outsiders also entered in the Santhali region, and Zamindars, collectors, Gomastas also entered in the region of the Santhals. The peace-loving, hard-working people, they were disturbed by these outsiders. After that, another term has been used, that is Santhal Pargana. What do you mean by the term Santhal Pargana? Actually, this Santhal Pargana extended from Prulia to the to the foothills of Raj Mahal and the area of Santhal Pargana is 1,366 square mile. The area of the Santhal Pargana was 1,366 square mile. You can see here. After that, the Santhal Pargana was surrounded by hills in how many areas? That is 866 square miles. After that, what was the area of the agrarian land? That is 500 square miles consisted of agrarian land. After that, according to the census of 1851, it says that there were 1,437 villages, and the numbers of the Santhali peoples, the population was 82,715. It was the total structure I have given you about Santhal Pargana. After that, now another question may be asked you about leaders. Who were the leaders of the Santhal rebellion of 1855-1856? The leaders, important leaders, two brothers, Sidhu and Kanu. They were the two brothers of Santhal rebellion. Another two brothers, they were Chand and Bhairav. They were the other two brothers who also played very important role. Another important leaders of Santhal rebellion were Bir Singh, Kalo Pramanik and Doman Manji. After that, Doman Manji was the leader. Now we will see next. We will see that causes of the Santhal rebellion 1855-1856. Cause number one, we will see that introduction of the permanent settlement system. In introduction of the permanent settlement system, we will see that I have already discussed in my previous class about the permanent settlement system. It was introduced by Lord Cornwallis in the year 1793, and it was introduced date, if you want to know, 22nd March 1793 in Bengal, and at that time Bihar and Odisha were the integral part of Bengal. So the important cause of the Santhal rebellion was permanent settlement. In Santhal Pargana, they were the people who had cleared the forest and doing agriculture there. But all of a sudden, when the permanent settlement system was introduced by the British government, okay, and revenue was fixed, the revenue was demanded from the Santhals, it became the number one cause for the Santhal rebellion of 1855-1856. Number second, you will see high rate of revenue and extortion of sub-revenues. I have told you that the permanent settlement system had a fixed revenue that was demanded from the Santhalis. But the Zamindars and sub-Zamindars, they demanded the revenue, and not only revenue, the extortion of sub-revenue, extra revenue they demanded. That also became the cause for the Santhal rebellion. Number three, if you go to see, exploitation of Santhal by moneylenders. Actually, in my previous class, I have already told you that when the Zamindars, when the contractors, when the Gomastas, when the sub-Zamindars demanded revenue and extra revenue from the poor tribal people, so tribal people did not have any other scope but to knock at the door of the moneylenders, and the moneylenders were ready to take full advantage from the helpless condition of the Santhalis. And ultimately, what we see that the moneylenders, they had given a loan to the Santhalis. But the rate of interest was very high, from between 50 and 500%. This was the rate of interest. And after taking the loan from the moneylender, there was no scope of coming out of that loan. All the life they had to pay the interest of that principal amount. After that, we will see that cheated by the foreign shopkeepers. Number four, here in this heading, what will we see? That the foreign shopkeepers, they also looted, they also cheated. In what respect, in what way they cheated the Santhali? We see that when the Santhali people, when they had gone to buy the grain cereals from the foreign shopkeepers, the foreign shopkeepers used to wait, less weight was given to them. And when the Santhalis used to come to sell their crops, the rate was, they used to buy the crops at a very low rate. Okay, in this way, they looted the Santhals. Afterwards, number five, if you go to see, in number five, you will see that the Lieutenant Governor of Bengal, his name is Frederick Halliday. He was the Lieutenant Governor of Bengal. He said that the law was there for the Santhali people, that if any Santhali would be violated, or their rules would be violated if they were looted, okay, civil and criminal laws were there. But according to Frederick Halliday, he said that the British law and civil and criminal laws were so expensive and so complicated, and it was so time consuming, that no Santhali, that illiterate Santhali, could not go to sue the case against any zamindar. So it was British civil and criminal laws were useless for these Santhalis. After that, we see that number six, propagation of Christianity. Propagation of Christianity, if we go to see, in propagation of Christianity, we will see that in the Santhali region, in Santhal Pargana, the Christian missionaries entered and they began to propagate about the Christianity. This was also not liked by the leaders, and ultimately they had revolted against the British government, against their zamindars, against their gomastas, and against the Christian missionaries. Ultimately, we see that next one, that is beginning of the rebellion. In this, here what we see, that after the implementation of permanent settlement system, when the permanent settlement system was introduced, okay, so the zamindars of Porarhat, after the introduction of the permanent settlement system, They acquired the large area on lease, and as a result, Santhal tribals living in Bakula, Birbhum, Chota Nagpur, and Hazaribagh, Manbhum, Midnapur, Palampur, Ranchi, etc. They lost their agricultural lands because of the introduction of the permanent settlement system. That is there. After that, we see that the landlords employs zamindars, the servants of zamindars, the servants of gomastas, the servants of contractors. They came to the Santhal Pargana, and they had cut the sal tree, and sal tree was accepted as a holy tree. It was adorned, it was worshipped by the Santhalis as very holy. So what happened? That British government, they ordered to clear the forest by uprooting, by cutting the sal tree to increase the land for the agriculture. In this way it was the beginning. Next. After that, next. What's it? Thank you.